Can you see my slides, sir?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. So I'll be going to present on this topics of AREDS and the market. So this is just a survey of the nutraceuticals available in the market. So whenever we are in our OPD, we are bombarded with all the informations by the medical reps on all the products which are useful for AREDS. And these formulations come in various shapes and size. And there are various claims by these medical reps and their teams, which we cannot be very sure when we are in OPD if we don't know the literature. So we are left up with all these on our table and we don't know what actually works. So AREDS was a multi-center trial which found that vitamin multi antioxidants and zinc help in reducing the incidence and slowing the progression of AMD. This was followed by a lot of studies, and later AREDS 2 came, which found that substituting lutein zeaxanthin for beta carotene reduces the risk of carcinogenic lung cancer. And they found that there was no role of omega 3 fatty acid. So these are the basic strong studies which we have to support our nutraceuticals. So with this in mind, we went ahead with this study. So basically, we made a list of all the nutraceuticals with their contents, which were available as samples given by these representatives to us. And we analyzed their contents and compared them to the AREDS formulation of 1 and 2. So basically, this was the study, and the results which we found were a little shocking, as we found that none of the brands could provide the formulation with the original content with a single day dosing. This is actually true, because even in the study, the participants received 2 tablets 2 times a day. So none of the brands could do that. When we compared them to the original formulation of AREDS 1 and 2, we found that only 3 of the brands had all the contents with actual dosage, and but they still needed BD dosing. And out of these 3, only 1 mentioned that they should be BD dosing. We found that 9 brands had all the contents of AREDS, but in insufficient quantity. And in 6 of these, vitamin C and vitamin E were the one which were insufficient. We found that AREDS 1 was very poorly represented in these samples, and only 2 had beta carotene, but that was also present in insufficient quantity. And also they had lutein and zeaxanthin along with this. So when we found that, when we compared them with other formulation, we found that lutein was the most commonest content, which was present in all of them. Other than this, zeaxanthin, which was not present in AREDS formulation, was the most commonest content. So we need to be very sure when we are following our medical reps, because they may say that the contents are original and according to the formulation, but they don't contain the exact concentration. So we found that zinc was present in various concentration, and as in the AREDS 2, the concentration was zinc was little undecided. So we found that it was present in 40 milligram, 12.5 milligram and 10 milligram. We found that omega 3 fatty acid was present in 5 of these brands, and astaxanthin was the most popular content, which was not mentioned in AREDS, but it was present in quite a few of the brands. This was in excess of lutein and zeaxanthin. So I would like to say the limitations of this study was that this was a non-exhaustive list, and the timeline of the products is an issue, because these were samples and we don't know whether they are still in circulation or they are out of production. And I would like to conclude by saying that we need to be aware of the exact concentration if we want to give according to AREDS, because the company may claim that this is according to AREDS, but when we see that, we will find out that the concentration is actually less. As in this case, you can see vitamin C and vitamin E is lesser in constituent, as compared to the AREDS formula. So in our OPD, we are very much guided by the pharma representatives, and we have to make an educative and informed decision when prescribing these medicines. Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Very nice, Dr. Anuj. What's your instance?
So, I would say that AREDS formula is actually very poorly represented in this, and we have to be very careful if we want to prescribe according to the AREDS, because we found that only 3 brands could fit the AREDS formulation, and that also to with the BD dosage, whereas the company only promoted 1 brand with BD dosage.
So which, can you name that brand?
Yeah, that was Ocubless and Vicolex.
Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much.